Human genetic editing is no longer science fiction. CRISPR cures are here. There are only two monogenic diseases, diseases caused by a single gene, that currently have a CRISPR-based treatment with regulatory approval in major markets. The first one is sickle cell disease. The second one is called transfusion-dependent beta thalassemia, a therapy called Casgevy. That's the CRISPR-Cas9 you've probably heard about. It edits a patient's own blood stem cells, so they start making a healthy form of hemoglobin. One-time treatment, designed to be curative for eligible patients, approved in the UK and the US starting in late 2023. That is a legit milestone, but here's the line you should draw in your brain: cured with approval versus being tested. Approved list? It's those two blood disorders, both tied to mutations in the HBB gene. Everything else we are seeing about CRISPR is promising, exciting, sometimes jaw-dropping science, but it is still in clinical trials. This technology is expanding fast. Let's take a look at some examples that are currently in clinical trials. Hereditary transthyretin amyloidosis, in vivo CRISPR, to switch off the liver gene that makes the toxic protein. Early human data looks strong. Hereditary angioedema, single-dose CRISPR aimed at slashing sudden swelling attacks. Big reductions reported in trials. Leber congenital amaurosis, certain inherited blindness being treated in the eye. That's usually viral gene replacement, not always CRISPR, but the results can be life-changing. Duchenne muscular dystrophy, teams testing CRISPR to fix or skip broken parts of the dystrophin gene. It's the moonshot category, high need, active trials, not approved. So when you hear CRISPR cured X, ask two quick questions. Is there regulatory approval? Is it a one-time functional cure, or just symptom control? For now, the gold star answer belongs to sickle cell disease and transfusion-dependent beta thalassemia with Casgevy. The take-home: CRISPR has crossed from promise to practice, but only for a couple of diseases so far. The pipeline is loaded, the data are maturing, and the next couple of years will tell us which conditions graduate from trial to treatment. Genetic engineering cures are a reality. We should celebrate the wins without overhyping the work still to do. But the future expansion of curable diseases will be a great benefit for humanity.